We would like with this interview outline the newest history of the Russian Maltese cultural connections. Why did the need arise to organize this Maltese Russian Friendship Society back in 1974? Was it your personal wish based on your studies of Marx or love to Russian culture?
As I wrote in my biography, and I always said, it's funny that Russia had so much culture and on the one hand, Russia is not represented. Well, I mean, our connection with Russia, you know, started with the Knights of Malta and so on and so forth. During the war, as I said, we were very involved. I mean, for us, we were kids. Yeah. When von Paulus surrendered, we celebrated and so on and so forth. My uncle used to mark the progress. My uncle was always accused of being pro-Russian, mm-hmm. which in those days was considered, in fact, in caricatures, he's represented with the Russian headdress. I can show you a picture. Mm-hmm. Yes. And every day he used to come home because his mother lived with us, and he used to have a coffee, and he used to listen to, which was shocking in those days, news from Moscow in English. Okay? So he was sort of seen as a
pro-Soviet, pro-Russian, red, exactly.
Okay, and then mm-hmm. we said, let's have a cultural society and so on. So there was this Pola Jews. And finally we said, okay. And I had restored the Museum of Fine Arts and mm-hmm. I opened it mm-hmm. in the 70th South Street. South Street. It was a lovely, lovely yeah. museum. I had the Chekhov statue mm-hmm. in the courtyard.
In the courtyard.
And mm-hmm. I said, let's make it public, you know. So we had that photograph, which yes. we put in mm-hmm. the papers, mm-hmm. and it created a lot of reaction. And then soon after, they invited me and Gerard Watsopardi to go to Moscow. Mm-hmm. And, I remember in those days, I mean, if you visited Moscow, you were told where to go and so on and so forth. But they treated us really well. So they made a program. I said, no, I want to go to the Bolshoi. Okay, go to the Bolshoi. They arranged for me to go to. And then I said, look, tomorrow morning I want to say Mass. So, okay. So I said Mass in Moscow. I remember at the House of Friendship, there was a Russian professor. He gave a lecture on Malta. Then when Moscow was here, there was talk of opening the Russian center.
Yes.
Richard England, the architect, restored it. I remember before we had that piano brought in mm-hmm. and so on and so forth. And we had the opening. And it was funny because for the opening it was packed with people. It was Zolina. And that Zolina was afraid of the ghost,
of the ghost.
she was really terrified of the ghost, okay? And to have concerts, Victory Day, and so on. And then, yes, they asked, what would you like to have for the opening? And we said, yes, we want some paintings of modern art. Mm-hmm. Kandinsky and mm-hmm. so on.
Malevich, Petrovodkin, yeah, those, yeah. yes.
Go to the Hermitage. There's a painting by Favre, which we'd love to borrow. Mm-hmm.
The Friendship Society was founded in 1974, and the center was opened, official center was opened in 1990.
That's right.
Emma, what was in between, let's say, what was the society, what was the main activities? Because you wanted to focus on culture,
It was more cultural, yes. And we organized trips, and as I said, going to Russia. Mm-hmm.
But we are going to discuss the projects which were successful and other projects which maybe you wish still to be implemented
yes.
or achieved.
Well, the book was a big thing.
The biggest.
Zolina was a fantastic person. But it was a good book.
Yeah, it's a great book.
And she had the best people to write and so on. Yes. And when the book came out, it was a big... Then they said that they're going to translate it and have it in Russian and... Mm-hmm. We had the thing in Paris, which was very good because... Mm-hmm.
And that was under auspice of UNESCO, I think.
Exactly.
It was.
People getting together, people getting the courage to speak about Russia. I mean, you can't imagine the idea. And then probably something came from Russia, obviously, to open a house in Valletta.
Oh, of course. It was important from both sides.
It became diplomatic.